Hey there, my tinfoil armadillos. I got some more stream games today, and these set of battles are all based around one theme. Yes, from the title, basically one balloon sent to rule them all. It's what I consider to be one of the most effective rushes in the game in terms of the ratio between how much it makes your opponent poops their pants versus how costly slash risky sending it is. Cue some controversy, cause I'm sure we got some wiser gentlemen in the comments ready to call me out on being wrong, but allow me to explain. I'm not explicitly saying you should send a BFB out on round 20 in every game you play, but in a decent amount of scenarios it's a pretty wise idea to do so. For example, pretty much all these games. I may be getting a little ahead of myself here for this first game, but let me just start with some extremely in-depth battles knowledge talk that only those with a high balloons IQ will understand. So, if your opponent is going ego, most of the time it's a good idea to send out a BFB, because the money you lose from it is less than the money your opponent loses by having to stop sending ego balloons to focus on defending with whatever money they have saved up. And if they were a little bit too greedy with their funds, well then good on you, chances are you get the W right then and there. That's the short explanation of why single BFBs are pretty OP. They're a pretty worthwhile rush to send now because of the fact that the 4.6 update or whatever patch it was lowered their eco loss by a huge margin. I think you only lose 100 and something now versus over 200 before. And that's a pretty big deal both if you're going farms and going ego. For example, in these matches I'm going full on ego because sometimes it's good to take a break from farms and switch up your gameplay a bit, cause dart farm or heli farm can get exhausting at times even though you have the opportunity to send 20k regro rainbow rushes at your sorry spike factory using opponents. So yeah. I don't really mind the 100 plus eco hit for the BFB all that much when I'm going eco, because the most likely result is that while your opponent is busy setting up their defense, you can just continue sending pinks or whatever income balloon and not have to worry about a counter rush. When you're an eco player, you don't really have the flexibility to both defend and counter rush at the same time. So this means you can widen the income gap even further despite losing 2,500 bucks on top of 100 plus eco. Focus your eyes on this match, cause I do exactly what I just said. A single BFB, followed up by constant pinks because I got nothing to worry about. And what do you know? I catch Testo count here in a pickle as he ends up falling to all the little insides that was spit out by the blimp. So worst case scenario your opponent defends and you don't really lose out on much, and best case scenario you saw right there. I guess you could say the same to other kinds of rushes to be honest though, like single round 18 Moabs and regrow leds are a bitch to defend and don't cost very much to the center, but I think part of why BFBs have the slight advantage is that it takes forever, forever ever, for the opponent to completely kill it off. Just make sure they don't have a boat, lol, otherwise you've just wasted your time and money. That's one of the few exceptions where you definitely shouldn't do that, although I'm sure everyone already knows that sending single BFBs versus a boat is about as smart as hand-feeding a wild grizzly bear in the forest. As for multiple BFBs and then some, well that's a different story, I hear a certain other video producer has. A topic on just that. Cough cough. Anyways, I did mention earlier that this is what you should do against eco users, but how about farm users? Good question, and I don't really know the answer, at least if it's a farm versus farm scenario. If you're eco versus farm, then probably not unless you're really confident that your opponent is incompetent. But for farm versus farm, I don't know. I haven't really done the math, but I reckon it's worse than the above scenarios because your opponent can just sell their defense and go back to building farms after defending. The same can't exactly be said with eco because you have to be wary of any subsequent rushes if you decide to sell more shit to make up your lost eco. So yeah, I think I've said enough regarding this. Let's talk about some more important stuff unrelated to battles now. I have a question. In the comments tell me, diarrhea or constant vomiting. Pick one. You may think this is such a random topic to bring up, but the reason I'm doing so is because one of those events happened to me very recently and it made me wonder, would I rather have the runny shits for 24 hours or the reversal of food rushing out of my mouth for the same amount of time? So about said event, I suppose I might as well share while I'm at it. This literally happened the day that I am writing this commentary, by the way. So the day was all fine and dandy, nothing out of the ordinary, had a homemade turnip cake for breakfast, went out afterwards to do some errands and whatnot. But then something in my tummy felt funny. I ignored it at first cause it wasn't really painful or anything, it just felt a little discomforting. But then it started getting worse and worse, and I was getting nauseous. Now normally this signals a trip to the bathroom to take a number two, but this felt differently than a usual stomach ache, so I wasn't sure emptying my bowels would help. Well, I did it anyway, and when I finished it definitely did not solve the problem. Shit was still feeling funny in my stomach for about another half an hour, and then it hit me. My body wanted me to flush my jolly edibles the same way it came in from. Do note that at the time I very, very rarely ever vomited in my life, so I wouldn't be able to tell you how it felt before then. I think the last time it happened to me was when I was a young boy and my father took me to the city. Sorry, couldn't resist. But back to the story, it was a good 30 seconds and the weirdest 30 seconds I've felt, a hot liquidy and chunky mess coming right out of your mouth in increments. I can't quite put my finger on it, but that feeling of the mashed up food coming up your digestive tract is just so unpleasant. Forget the acidic taste you get in your mouth, that didn't bother me too much. So yeah, after that I felt like I was on top of the world now that everything's been flushed out, or so I thought. Dopamine is a hell of a drug. So having hardly vomited before, I didn't exactly have the knowledge or did research on what to do after experiencing an episode like that. I just figured it would help to continue ingesting water and whatnot, and a couple of hours later I binged on a couple of berries. Big mistake, cause the same feeling hit me like a truck soon after, and I once again had to experience the amazing feeling of stomach contents exiting the wrong way. Part of me insisted I should probably, you know, just not eat for the time being, but after doing a bit of the wrong research and parents persuading me to eat cause I haven't truly and took any kind of food all day, I very slowly nibbled on a bowl of rice since the internet told me that's a good stale food choice post-vomit. You know what happens next. I guess I skimmed over the part where it said you should probably only start eating again once you stop getting butterflies in your stomach and actually feel an urge to eat, aka 6 hours or more. I've learned my lesson by now, but not after having to experience hours of on and off gruesome torture. As for how this compares to diarrhea, boy, let me tell you. I've had many stomach aches in the past that were taken care of fairly quickly. But the one time I did have actual diarrhea, I have to say, it's probably worse than constant vomiting personally. Trying not to have recency bias affect my opinions. But if I can recall how I felt during those diarrhea moments, I think I'll choose vomiting because for one, it saves toilet paper from having to wipe your bottom all the time. Paper doesn't come free, boys. Second, for the most part you feel like shit throughout your diarrhea episode, while for vomiting there's this grace period where you feel like completely normal, if you get what I mean. Also accessibility, if you're a classy citizen chances are you want to release your diarrhea bowels into the point, but for puking you have the option of choosing the toilet, the tub, a trash can slash bucket, or the 10th grade science teacher that always picked on you to answer their questions. Asterisk on that last point, because such option may not be as accessible compared to others. So yeah, case in point, both are hell to deal with, but I'm going to have to pick vomiting again if I had to, cause nothing's worse than cramping over your toilet seat with a bad ache. That feels worse than getting rejected by your high school crush or finding out that your crush already has a sugar daddy. So again, tell me which of the two options you'd choose. Graphic stories too are welcome if you wish. And if you were wondering why I didn't keep my promise of streaming again during that week, well, there's your answer for the most part. I'll make sure to sneak a couple more in the future as long as I don't feel like I want to die. Surprisingly, I rambled for quite a while there, and we've pretty much used up our commentary time, so it's time I sign off now. As you can see from these games, single BFBs are deadly. That is all. 9 out of 10 would recommend. Have a red day.